I was looking for a last step protection with a similar, if not better, water behavior than the insanely hydrophobic Sonox Brilliant Shine Detailer, and I think I found one. Welcome to Road to Detailing. In this video, I'm going to compare ADBS Synthetic Spray Wax with Sonox BSD, but I need you to keep your eyes peeled until the very end of this video because it won't be easy to pick a winner out of this comparison. If you are new to the channel and you love taking care of your car, consider to subscribe and explore the car detailing products together. With that being said, let's jump right into the middle of this topic.
A good preparation is always important to achieve the best possible performance of a wax or sealant. So I went over on a full chemical decontamination, started with a touchless tar removal by Wasco Prewash, which is a very interesting product to use, then it was followed up by an iron remover from ADBL. There is a lot to go through with this chemical decontamination process and it will be coming up next on the channel soon, so stay tuned for that. Now, strip off any remaining waxes and sealants, then move on to the last preparation step by using a panel wipe to provide a bare surface for the products to bond and achieve maximum performance. The sun was pretty strong this day and didn't help much to ease the application of any of the products. No surprise that avoiding direct sunlight is the best choice to do. However, I had to deal with that. I just wanted to let you know this fact because it really affected the user experience on a certain way. Anyways, the beauty of ADBL Synthetic Spray Wax is that it offers different ways for the application and usage, as you can use that on its own or on top of any other existing protection you already have. Also, being a spray and wipe formula, you can spray the wax onto dry or slightly wet panels or onto a microfiber cloth, then just wipe off. No hazing, no waiting time, simple as that. As you can see, I choose to spray a few mists onto the panel, spread with a microfiber block, then wipe off with a 500 GSM super plush cloth. Hence the strength of the sun on the bonnet, spreading and wiping of the spray wax wasn't the best experience at all, because it tended to dry very quickly, although I can't stress that enough, this isn't recommended circumstances to have for an ideal application. On the other side, the bubblegum scent during and after the application is just really nice to have. I still can smell it on the paintwork after days of application, which I really like. I used exactly the same application method with Sonox BSD and the application experience was more or less identical. Although BSD didn't dry that quick as the spray wax, which could be down to its thicker consistency. The coconut scent of BSD is also nice to have, but wasn't that appealing as the bubblegum scent. At least something I could easily decide which one is better with. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment you were all waiting for, the bottle of the hydrophobics. Before we move on to see the fight with an APC massage, pause the video and share the winner in a comment. Next up is a quick APC contact wash, which is always great experience to watch, but I wouldn't call this a proper longevity test at all, wouldn't be fair. what I can say so far is that I had to do the whole application and strip process 3 times because of an issue with my camera, and unfortunately I have lost the first test I have done where the SprayVex did very slightly better on this experiment. However, the results here are pretty much identical again, although ADBI claims a longevity of 2000 km. So I reapplied both products and left the bonnet at 50-50, so I can see the real-life longevity better once I hit the 2000 km mark, then I will do an update on this subject. I think the differences are very minor between the two products, to be fair. Both tend to collect dust and pollen after a few days of driving, and the finish they leave on the surface aren't too slick at all. I was expected for a bit more gloss level from ADBI's synthetic SprayVex over BSD. However, I don't have a fancy gloss meter to measure the exact levels properly, and it is something which I can't really give you back through the camera lens. I think the SprayVex has a slightly better gloss level, but yet again, you take it or leave it, please share your experience down below in the comment section.
If you have made it this far, I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, likes are free, so please give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe to the channel for videos like this and turn on the notification bell to never miss on my weekly uploads. All your support helps the channel growing and is much appreciated. Thanks for watching, thanks for being here, take care, and see you soon.